I've seen some families, you kind of wonder if they're glad to be a part of each other. You're a child of God tonight. I'm thankful to call you brother. I'm thankful to call you sister. Thank you so much for being here tonight. It is a delight. It is a delight to have Hope Sound Bible College, both the ministerial department and the music department, to be represented here tonight. Brother Gray told us this afternoon this is the first IH convention held in the state of Florida. And we started over at Hope Sound with this type of a setting. This is called From the Heart, where two preacher, young preacher men are going to deliver to you what God has laid upon their heart in a 10-minute window.
Wow.
10-minute window. Now, when we were over at Hope Sound, they had a big clock on the back of the wall. And when they started, that clock started rolling. They knew exactly where they were. Last night, we were in Kissimmee, Florida, and they had two clocks. One on each wall. Fellas, you don't have any clocks. Except me. In just a moment, we're going to start the clock on them. They'll have 10 minutes each. And if they don't get done in that 10 minutes, I'm going to very kindly stand up beside them and let them know it's time to zip it. Incidentally, that's what I need to do right now. I know that you would much rather hear them than hear me. Amen?
Amen.
I really half expected that. It's also a delight to have the music group, music from Hope Sound Bible College represented here tonight. We had a quartet the first couple of nights. We have a ladies' trio. Yeah. Actually, we're going to go into a quartet mode, at least for the first number. It's so thrilling to have them. Would you come and sing for us tonight? God bless them. Listen, open up your hearts, and I know God will have something for you.
Good.
So precious is Jesus, my Savior, my King. His praise all the
precious to me. Amen. Praise the Lord tonight. Praise God. Two young men, Hope Sound Ministerial Department, and I told our first brother tonight that I'm probably going to mess up his name. And I'm afraid of that because it sounds like he may be involved in the mafia. Alex Kim Seiko. Close enough. No knife in my back. So. My brother, come and give us what the Lord has laid on your heart. You amen him. You know that helps the preacher.
Yes.
Amen him. In 10 minutes, what does he have to say to the Holy Spirit?
Yeah. Well, good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I will tell you, I am not part of the mafia. I would like to call to your attention the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2. We're going to read verses 1 through 10. Verses 1 through 10. And we're going to have you please stand and listen to God's word. It reads like this: Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men, who shall be able to teach others also. Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please who hath chosen him to be a soldier. And if a man also strive for masteries, yet is he not crowned, except he strive lawfully. The husbandman that laboreth must be first partaker of the fruits. Consider what I say, and the Lord give thee understanding in all things. Remember that Jesus Christ is the seed of David, was raised from the dead according to my gospel, wherein I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even unto bonds, but the word of God is not bound. Therefore I endure all things for the elect's sake, that they may also obtain the salvation which is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. You may be seated. In these verses, I want to touch a little bit about the exhortation of Paul to Timothy to be a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Now, I want to look at least three aspects of a soldier this evening. The first is a soldier, number one, is loyal. Number two, a soldier is valiant. And number three, a soldier is dedicated. In the Roman army, during Paul's ministry, the Roman army was the most powerful army in the world. Now, a soldier in the Roman army was part of a specific unit of men. This soldier was expected to be loyal, to never falter in battle, and even though he was wounded, to keep fighting.
Amen.
Now, what does that say about us? We are a part of the army of God.
Right.
So does that not mean we should be loyal to God?
Amen.
Unto the death?
Yes.
You gotta think about that. And we're gonna look at what Paul expected Timothy to do as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. First, Paul expected Timothy to be diligent, like a good soldier. Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. A soldier was expected to do work, specific duties every day. And so, likewise, us as Christians, we have specific duties that God has told us.
Sure.
Paul also expected Timothy to teach others how to be good soldiers of Jesus Christ, as it says in verse 2, And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou unto faithful men, who shall be able to teach others also. The primary reason that we are soldiers of Jesus Christ is to go out and conquer, per se, regions for the Lord. The Roman army, their sole purpose was to go out and subdue tribes, neighboring tribes of Rome, or nowadays Italy. The same is for us. We're to go out into the world and win other people to Christ. Paul also exhorts Timothy to suffer as a soldier of Jesus Christ. Now, if you consider the conditions that many of these Roman soldiers fought in, many of these Roman soldiers fought in terrible conditions. Sometimes it would be blazing heat, sometimes it would be pouring rain, and even sometimes winter snows. Now, I have to say something. The Christian life is not a bed of roses. Mm-hmm. I'm sure many of you who have been Christians for much longer than I have can testify to that, and I can as well. Because even though I may not be very old, I have had my trials.
Sure.
And Paul exhorts Timothy to suffer. The Epistle of James says to count it all joy when we have to pass through sufferings and trials. Mm-hmm. Are we willing to suffer for Christ? Or as soon as the battle gets hard, do we turn tail and run? You know what happened to Roman soldiers when they turned tail and run? They were killed. Now, that's not to say we're going to die the second we turn tail and run physically, but we die spiritually. We need to be careful. It says, as a soldier of Jesus Christ, Timothy should depart from the world and his desires. It says in verse 4, no man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier. A Roman soldier many times had to go days without eating. He had a specific diet of food, specific armor that he wore, specific clothing, specific shoes. And he could not allow himself to partake of delicacies because it would harm his life as a soldier. The same with us. We cannot afford to become friends with this world because they will burden us down. A Roman soldier had to be a specific weight. If he was over that weight, it would bear him down. It would cause him to lose strength and stamina in battle. And the same with us. We should throw away all burdens in order to keep going towards the goal. But Paul reminds Timothy of his captain. Who is Timothy's captain? It's Jesus Christ. He should remember the sacrifice of Jesus Christ in verses 7 and 8. It says, consider what I say, and the Lord give thee understanding in all things. Remember that Jesus Christ of the seed of David was raised from the dead according to my gospel. Jesus had to suffer and die for our sins. He set the ultimate example for us to follow. And in the Roman army, the centurion or the captain of these men was to be the first one to go into battle. The men were to follow him into battle. Now, who are you following tonight?
That's it.
Are you following your captain?
That's it.
Good.
Or are you following someone else? In closing, I would like to look at the example that Paul sets for us. Verses 9 and 10. We'll read that. It says, wherein I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even unto bonds, but the word of God is not bound. Therefore I endure all things for the elect's sake, that they may also obtain the salvation which is in Christ Jesus with eternal joy. Let me ask you something. How far are you willing to go to further the kingdom of God?
Yeah, that's right.
How far am I willing to go?
Come on.
Yes. Are we willing to step outside of our comfort zones?
No.
To reach those who we may not see as reachable. How far are we willing to go? Paul went overseas. Paul suffered shipwrecks, multiple. He was sick many times. Sometimes he didn't have food. He was beaten. He was even stoned and left for dead. Yet he kept going because the goal was still further up.
Praise God.
Are we willing to pass through the sin?
Yeah, that's it.
Are we willing to suffer for Christ?
No,
I hope we can. And I hope that is every one of our goals. That we may strive to be a good soldier of Jesus Christ.
Good.
Amen.
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 Have you ever been?
Why do we not see God moving as he did in the past? I believe it is because we've become so self-reliant that prayer has become a check the block instead of an earnest cry to God. God is the same today as He was yesterday. He is as strong today as He was 1,000 years ago. Trust in the Lord. Ask Him to build your faith. Lastly, tonight I would like to talk to you about worship. Personal worship is our primary responsibility. We were created in the image of God for the purpose of worshiping Him. It is not enough that we come to church on Sunday morning, Sunday night, or even Wednesday night. Our lives must be lived as worship. Everything that we do and say should bring glory to God. You are praying daily. He is answering prayer, and your faith is building. Now let us worship Him daily. Let us praise Him for His mercy and grace, and thank Him for the answers to prayer. Do not wait to worship, but rather constantly worship. May those around you see Christ in you, even in the midst of trials and tribulations. When you feel you have nothing else to praise Him for, remember that He saved your soul from a fiery hell. Thank Him for it. God sent His Son to save the lost. You have experienced a love like no other. In 1972, NASA launched the exploratory space probe Pioneer 10. According to Leon Jarrett from Time magazine, the satellite's primary mission was to reach Jupiter, photograph the planet and its moons, and beam data back to Earth about Jupiter's magnetic field, radiation belts, and atmosphere. Scientists regarded this as a bold plan, for at the time, no Earth satellite had gone beyond Mars, and they feared the asteroid belt would destroy the satellite before it could reach its target. But Pioneer 10 accomplished its mission and much, much more, swinging past the giant planet in November of 1973. Jupiter's immense gravity hurled Pioneer 10 at a higher rate of speed towards the edge of the solar system. At 1 billion miles from the Sun, Pioneer 10 passed Saturn. At some 2 billion miles, it hurled past Uranus, Neptune at nearly 3 billion miles, Pluto at almost 4 billion miles. By 1997, 25 years after its launch, Pioneer 10 was more than 6 billion miles from the Sun. And despite that immense distance, Pioneer 10 continued to beam back radio signals to the scientists on Earth. Perhaps most remarkable, Jarrett writes, those signals emanate from an 8-watt transmitter, which radiates about as much power as a bedroom nightlight and takes more than 9 hours to reach Earth. The little satellite that could was not qualified to do what it did. Engineers designed Pioneer 10 with a useful life of just 3 years, but it kept going and going. By simple longevity, its tiny 8-watt transmitter radio accomplished more than anyone thought possible. So it is when we offer ourselves to the Lord. God can work through someone with an 8-watt ability. God cannot work, however, with someone who quits. As we close tonight, I want to leave you with a challenge to keep pressing higher. Make time daily to get alone with God. It can be in the morning or at night or while driving in your car. Put your faith in Him and lean on the everlasting arms. Trust Him to answer your prayers and strengthen and help you. Live your life as a witness to the Lord and God. Worshiping Him in all that you do. Share your growing faith with those around you and testify to your relationship with Christ. Let us better ourselves for the kingdom of God and remember that God can use anyone as long as we are willing. Psalms 121, 1 through 3. I will lift up mine eyes to the hills from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber.
Praise
God. May God bless you.
Pray.
Amen.
Soldier who fed, who lay in the battle for the Lord. Live.
us on the way tonight. Thank you, Hope Sound Bible College, both these two men, these young ladies, for coming. 3-hour trip off somewhere there around that just to come and sing and preach for you tonight. I am so appreciative of them doing that. Just a small little intermission. Don't go too far. If you need the restrooms, you know where they are, but get right back in here. We're getting ready to go right into the main service tonight. Thank you so much for being here. God bless you. We trust that He'll touch your heart through the service tonight.